HarperTeen and Harper Audio present All of This Is True, a novel by Lygia Day Peñaflor. Performed by Amielynn, Abellera, Nora Hunter, Taylor Meskimen, Arnell Powell, Jay Aaseng, Jesse Bernstein, Adam Connor, Sharmila Devar, M. Eldridge, Susan Hanfield, Merritt Hicks, Rachel Jacobs, Mike Rylander, and Ann Simmons.
For a woman, betrayal has no sense. One cannot betray one's passions. Coco Chanel.
Unedited video footage, Naked Truth TV. Nelson Anthony interviews Mary Tan and Penny Panzarella. May 3rd through 17, 2018. Mary. So tell me about Fatima Rowe. There are a lot of people who are curious about her right now.
All right. But I'm just going to say this outright because it's probably the one thing we still agree on, me, Soleil, and Penny. We were shallow before we met Fatima Rowe. We were all about the scene. You know what I mean about the scene, the parties, the trinkets, the lifestyle. We hosted.
Hosted?
House parties at Penny's place. It feels like forever ago. Ugh. All those people, the throbbing music, handling all that money.
What money?
We collected a cover charge to fund subsequent parties.
Very industrious.
That's us. We met on orientation day in seventh grade when we were grouped together for the Graham scavenger hunt. Winners become orientation leaders the following year. We won by splitting up and then finding the last clue together, the school seal on the roof.
You're a good team.
We were, yes. Before this. Anyway, our parties were epic. The last one we hosted was casino night. We had game tables and chocolate poker chips. It won't be outdone for years.
That's pretty impressive.
Oh, please. We thought taking selfies on the roulette table was the stuff of life. The reality was we were bored out of our skulls. You see, the basic human need for emotional intimacy can't be satisfied by a sushi station or a celebrity DJ. Fatima made us realize that. She changed everything for us. Even that phrase, the stuff of life, that's something I picked up from her. I wouldn't have said that just now if it weren't for her. I probably would have said something more like, we thought taking selfies was so Vogue-worthy. But now I'm saying the stuff of life, because Fatima pretty much gave us a whole new language, a new way of thinking, of living. When she took us in, all of a sudden I realized, we all realized, that we were starving to be part of something meaningful. Becoming friends with Fatima Rowe, I mean, actually being part of her inner circle, was it.
Were you a fan of her novel, Undertow?
Definitely. That's how this whole thing started. Absolutely. All of us were fans. Well, we girls were, anyway. Jonah was along for the company. But still, even he was fascinated by her. I read Undertow when it first came out.
When I found out how young Fatima was,
barely out of college, it made sense that I felt close to her writing. She got me. I love Undertow as if it's a living being, which is passion in its truest form. That's what separates a casual interest from a passion. I credit Fatima for my understanding of that. You see, you can be in love with a thing the way you can be in love with a person.
A thing can physically trigger the same chemical responses as another human can.
Oxytocin and vasopressin.
Fatima taught me this.
Her book proved it. But I just cringe at how the media is comparing it to other novels, because what you have to understand is that Undertow was never a Harry Potter phenomenon. I mean, nobody's wearing Undertow Halloween costumes. There's no Undertow Disney theme park. But that's what's so authentic about it. If you love Undertow, it's because you get it, not because there's a Tom Hanks movie and a Happy Meal. This book has a much quieter, more thoughtful following. And to me, it feels more genuine to be part of something personal like that. Think about it. If you know and love Undertow, and you meet someone else who truly knows and loves Undertow, instantly she's your kind of person. You cannot possibly feel that kind of connection with, say, a Hunger Games fan, because that fandom is just too big. It's too commercial. It's like, of course you like the Hunger Games. Everyone likes it. It's a big deal, right? But Fatima's following is simply more intimate. Her novel takes a certain more concerning or discerning reader. So to be a fan of Undertow is deeper. There's an understanding between people who love it. We share an appreciation for the depths of its message and for its language. There's a simpatico between Undertow fans. It's one beating heart meeting another beating heart. There I go. I'm sounding like her again. I know, but I'm grateful for that, for her words. The simpatico and the beating hearts. Do you know why I agreed to speak with you, Nelson?
You were impressed that Naked Truth is number 47 in the ratings?
Hardly. It's because you were the only reporter who actually read both Undertow and The Absolution of Brady Stevenson. I asked every journalist who contacted me.
Oh, really?
I don't care about ratings or Emmys or how famous a journalist is or isn't.
Thanks.
I wanted to talk to someone who isn't out to persecute Fatima for her art and who would understand how incredibly lucky we were to connect with her. And you do get it, don't you?
Yes. I really do. That's why I want you to tell the side of this story that no one else is telling, about the real Fatima Rowe. No one knew her the way you did. This is your forum, Miri.
I can't tell you how much I appreciate that, Nelson. I knew I chose the right person. Oh, I'm sorry. I've been so rude. I should have offered you something to drink. May I get you something?
No, thank you.
Water, iced tea. We have a soda stream.
I'm good, thanks.
Suit yourself.
Can you talk about how you met Fatima?
Yes. You see, we had a plan when we met her. Soleil will never admit to this now, but we went to Fatima's signing at Book Review with, I exaggerate you not, a premeditated plan to get close to her. It was our goal to get noticed by her. That's why I cannot and will not understand their outrage over the new book. Seriously, Soleil and Penny have become so ungrateful when what we wanted from the beginning was to be associated with her. It's sad, really, how bitter Soleil and Penny have grown. I should pity them, honestly. I feel sorry for people who don't believe in loyalty.
They have a reason to be upset, though. Fatima did base her new book on you girls and Jonah without even telling you. The book isn't flattering. You're not angry at Fatima at all?
We befriended Fatima because she's a writer. You can't hug a lion and then be surprised when he bites you.
But Jonah was beaten into a coma in the Graham School parking lot because of what Fatima wrote.
It wasn't her fault.
The cops found a copy of Absolution at the crime scene. The perpetrators left it on Jonah's chest while he was fighting for his life.
Dateline and Mario Lopez just love to play up that detail, don't they? It's sick, the way attractive women are portrayed by the media. They're either victims or villains because those make the sexiest headlines. Ugh. It's easy to win ratings by connecting the crime to a young pretty writer, isn't it? Think for a second. What do they plaster on the screen every time they cover this story? Fatima's face.
You're right.
Half the time they don't even show Jonah's.
Beautiful author who seduced teens into revealing their dirty secrets, now responsible for boys' coma. Full story at 11.
That's cheap bait. That's not the truth.
Then what is the truth?
That there isn't anyone to blame. You read the book. Art doesn't harm. Art saves. You know, we shared hours upon hours of conversations with Fatima about creative freedom and artistic expression. Soleil documented every word from Fatima's mouth on her phone and her laptop, so I thought she respected all of that. Really, you couldn't stop Soleil from documenting. She was nothing less than obsessed. Her notes were all,
Fatima this, Fatima that.
Ask her.
I'm not interviewing Soleil. She turned me down. Low ratings. Penny agreed only when I told her that you were in.
Huh. Then you should look into getting a hold of Soleil's journal. That would shed light on how desperate she was for Fatima's attention. Seriously, get her journal and her emails with Fatima, too.
I made an offer, but she already sold them to New York City Magazine.
You're kidding.
No. They're featuring them in a series of online articles starting today. You can see them on your phone, actually. The public's been glued to stories about high school violence for a couple years now. Fatima, whatever her involvement, has added a whole new element of interest.
Well, there it is, side by side with an article about Jonah and Fatima Rowe.
Oh, look, a photo of Fatima. What did I tell you?
A nice byline, Soleil. What a hypocrite.
How do you mean?
Soleil hates Fatima for writing about her, but she's publishing journal entries about Fatima? She can't possibly defend that.
I hear you.
Screw her, right? If Soleil's publishing her side, I'm not holding back.
You shouldn't. Don't let her control public opinion. Don't let her get the last word.
No way in hell.
So talk to me. Tell me more. What happened at the book signing?
The night of the book signing, we took the back of the line on purpose. We strategized that we could talk with Fatima for longer if we were last. We might even get a chance to walk her out. We wanted pictures and to ask her to follow our Instagrams. The back of the line was also Lay's idea. She was the writer, as you all know, as the whole free world now knows. She was the one who wanted to wriggle her way into Fatima's life. Now, that's not even the extent of it. Soleil didn't just want to be in Fatima's life. She wanted to be Fatima. Like I said, people always want to be in the front of the line. But there's a different strategy for everything. Well, I was terrified to meet her, to be honest. I'd built up that moment in my mind. It felt so once in a lifetime. I didn't want to make a fool of myself. Have you ever met someone famous that you loved? Isn't it surreal? To suddenly, after dreaming about it for so long, see that person in front of you? I mean, flesh and blood and breathing and moving and talking, and you can reach out and touch them if you wanted to?
I saw Quentin Tarantino once.
So then you know.
Yeah, I get it.
Well, Fatima was poised and very striking. She's attractive, that's a fact. But in person, it's more about her presence than her looks. She's so completely self-possessed that you really can't help but just stare at her. Plus, what was so amazing was to look at her and know that undertow came out of her brain. I don't even know how to describe that. I kept thinking about how she had conceptualized this novel that I love.
She had crafted it and created it out of her own head. And she was so petite. I don't know why, but that was surprising to me. I just kept marveling at her. How could all these words and thoughts come out of her? Am I sounding like an insane person?
Not at all. I couldn't get over how tall Tarantino was.
Really?
6 feet, easily.
See, it's overwhelming when you see these people in a room with you.
Tarantino was on the street. I passed him on my way to the subway.
Great. Well, with Fatima, I was so nervous. I had to keep going to the bathroom. We waited in that line for...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.